Port call optimization ensures safe and efficient vessel visits from departure to arrival. Let us show you step by step how we do this in the Port of Rotterdam. The charterer checks whether the vessel fits at the berth and signs the charter party. The captain makes a voyage planning from berth to berth. The charterer and captain can work with the same information about the exact location and depth of the berth to ensure the safety of the port and berth. When the vessel enters this area, the terminal is notified to send the current berth planning to the agent. The agent confirms the berth planning and shares it with the harbor master. The harbor master translates the berth planning into a pilot boarding planning, which is confirmed by the agent. The agent informs the captain so that the vessel's sailing speed can be adjusted for the lowest possible fuel consumption. These four steps are built into the port community system and formalized through agreements with terminals and secures the planning of the vessel prior to arrival in the waiting area. The vessel arrives at the pilot boarding place on time or sails to the anchorage or drifting area. The arrival time is determined by improved wind forecasts and automatically calculated tidal windows, among other factors. In the event of peak demand for nautical services, the Harbor Coordination Center will consult with the nautical services regarding their remaining available capacity. If the capacity is insufficient, peak moments will be smoothed out to avoid last-minute adjustments in the planning. Anchorage Area 5 will be increased to allow new vessels from the Maasvlakte to safely wait. If the vessel cannot or does not want to anchor, for example during a storm, it can go to the drifting area. To reduce the exchange time between vessels, incoming container ships can dock at a lay-by berth while their berth is still occupied. We can reduce the response time for tugs with lay-by berths for tugs in the Yangtze Canal. In the event of a delayed vessel, the waiting tugboats are redirected to another vessel that is ready, thereby avoiding a knock-on effect with delays. Capacity requirements for nautical services will be leveled, starting with a safety-based license for tugs. During a code red, consideration is given to whether the vessel should remain out of port. Upon arrival and departure, the process of rigging the gangway has been accelerated by a procedural adjustment. This saves about an hour and is safer for the crew. There is often a shortage of tugboats during storms. The shoreside mooring system shore tension is used to free up tugboat capacity. The day before a code red, a check is performed to ensure that there are enough tugs and shore tension is available to keep all vessels safely alongside. More time is needed to bunker alternative fuels. At the Maasvlakte, we are considering whether a lay-by berth can be provided for this. The terminal shares the latest update of the end time of the cargo operations with the agent. The bunker barge also shares the end time with the agent. The agent can accept these end times and pass it on to the harbor master as the departure time. These three steps are in the port community system and formalized through covenants with terminals and permits with bunker parties. Thank you for joining us. We hope this gives you a clear understanding of how we ensure safe and efficient port calls at the Port of Rotterdam.